So how did I get here? I ask myself that question a lot. I'm just kidding. I actually come here happily via the world of the theater, where I was for 25 years, first as an actress and then as a producer. And to me, it all makes sense because it's all about the story. That's what interests me. As a child, I loved to listen to stories. Then I wanted to tell them, and I became an actress. Then I wanted to help them be told. That's why I went into producing. And now I'm back to listening to them, but with the advantage of education, the wisdom of years. Everybody has a story, and all conflict is embedded with their story, and their stories are embedded in their conflict. So it all makes a great deal of sense to me. The way I actually got into mediation was that a colleague of mine told me that she was going to take a course in mediation, and a light went on. So I looked at my potential resources and found Teachers College, the program in organizational psychology with a track in mediation. And that was a wonderful experience. And when I got my degree in 1998, almost 20 years ago, I went on to work in the Bronx for a little bit and then got the job of director at the Westchester and Rockland Mediation Centers, and I was there for 19 years. Now I've left and I'm focusing mostly on teaching, training, and working as a consultant with a small private mediation concern. The story that I think will resonate mostly with students is one that took place when I was a fairly new mediator, having just received my degree. And it was in the Bronx and referred to us by the police. It was a conflict that started between two children in a family, but it grew very quickly to encompass the entire family and then a little bit more to include neighbors. And it became a real Hatfield and McCoy kind of situation, only with guns and violence and anger. So the police who referred it into us really were hoping that we could sort of bring down the temperature. And I was a fairly new mediator, and my co-mediator was very experienced. And we started out all together with one family on one side and the other family on the other side. There were about six with this family and four with this, and it was cacophonous. Furious threats. And my co-mediator suggested that we change the shape of this. So we had the parents all leave the room, go into two separate rooms with guards, and we mediated between the young people. And they were amazing. They had experienced real trauma in their lives. Each member of the family had lost somebody else to violence, gun violence mostly, and they really wanted this to end. And they were prepared to give up their position and move towards reconciliation, but they weren't sure about their families or the neighbors. So then, when we called the parents to come back, we had all the young people on one side and all the people from both families on the other side. And the mediation was no longer about the feud, but about these young people asking their families to stop the violence. It was very moving to me. I was so impressed with these young people, and it really highlighted for me how collaborative dialogue can change the world, albeit one family, one community at a time.